Welcome to a brand new Coffee Tech Break session, your place to be for the latest and greatest on the Poly products. Today is something I wanted to show you, and that is a deep dive into the One Touch Down. So I showed you in my previous session the whole requirements and components that you need. Now, one of the items which I really got some questions about is the One Touch DAO. So how does specifically does that look like? And One Touch DAO is really a great feature to use. It works on both Studio X and the G7500 and the integrator box, but also you can use it on HDX, Group Series, and Visual Pro with Trio, and there's a lot of other devices which are also supported by the One Touch DAO. Now, it comes free of charge with Rail Connect, or if you have a Poly endpoint or Polycom endpoint. So I think that's really powerful, and it offers so much additional benefits in the meeting room for a user who just walks in and can join his meeting. So I can show you that quickly, as I showed you also in my previous video. So you really got those meetings in here, and you just press the join button. So let me, for example, press here my Teams meeting. As you will see,
welcome to Poly Real Connect.
All the information is filled out, and you don't have to do anything. All the information is filled out, and it's just waiting here for the other participants. Now, same is for Zoom. As you will see, it will automatically put in the meeting ID, etc. So you don't have to do anything. You will see it quickly, and here you go. It directly jumps into the meeting. And so compared to favorites, which is also a possibility. So let's say you don't have the One Touch DAO service yet, you can also create favorites. But what you will see, for example, if I join a Zoom lobby now, what you will see is you need to punch in the meeting ID. And so we'll join the meeting and ask you for the meeting ID.
Then enter your meeting ID, followed by the pound sign again.
Exactly. So here you need to punch your meeting ID, which is comes available in the invite, and you can jump in. So that works also as a quick start. But of course, the One Touch DAO, I can imagine that's the most optimal one. In case you don't have those providers configured yet, and you want to get started quickly, you can also use device mode. Or how we call it also USB mode. So here you can just walk into the meeting room and use the video client on your laptop, plug in the USB cable, which goes directly into the Studio X family or the G7500, and you can just use the video client on your laptop and just reuse the camera, speaker, and mic in the Studio X family, or any camera and that's connected to your G7500. This is also, I think, a very powerful use case. Now, how do you configure the One Touch DAO, and how does that look like? So what did I configure to make this happen? And also, if you got a touchscreen, as I have here, you can also use that join button. So it gives you really a great flexibility and also ease of use. Just use Outlook or the Teams client, schedule the meeting, any provider, and you're able to join. Now, let me show you in a quick presentation how that topology looks like, and also how the management portal of One Touch DAO looks like. Now, let me quickly run that through. So, as I said, One Touch DAO comes free with a Poly endpoint. So if you buy Rail Connect, you got your One Touch DAO service coming with it. But if you got a Polycom or Poly endpoint, you can also request to use One Touch DAO. As it's not only for Teams, but you can also use it with Zoom via the Zoom Room connector. You can use it with WebEx, BlueJeans, or any app, any platform out there, as long as it has a HTTP SIP entry. And I think that is very, very important. Now, how does the workflow look like? Just to quickly run it through. So on the right side, you first schedule your meeting using Outlook or using your Teams client. Now, what is important is that you got this Real Connect information in there. And so if you don't have that information in there, it will not show up. And so this is very important. This will end up in your mailbox. This can be a user or a resource mailbox for testing. I'm also using a lot a user mailbox, but in production, I would say take a resource mailbox as that is much easier. And also if you look at the licensing. Now, what will happen is the Studio X G7500 and even HDX or Group Series, they will retrieve using the OneTouch DAO that mailbox, and automatically on your device, on your TC8, it will show you the join button. I think that's very powerful. And you only point to otd@plcm.vc, because that is the server that you will be using, and it's sort of passed through to Exchange Online or Google Mailbox, so you can have different mailboxes there. Now, the same is for your Zoom invites. So you just use Outlook, schedule your Zoom invite, make sure you got your connector license, which will add SIP and H323 to your invite. This will be available in the mailbox. So the devices will pull that mailbox using the OneTouch DAO, and that will make sure you have that join button on the screen. Very powerful. This is the workflow used by the system. Now, let me get into OneTouch DAO. So as you see, it's not only for Zoom, for Real Connect. No, there's a lot of other providers. And as I said, this platform can be updated very quickly. It's a cloud platform, a separate platform. We're able to innovate on that very, very quickly. Now, let me show you the OneTouch DAO web portal. So you go to otd.plcm.vc and you sign in with your Microsoft or your Google account here. And here you can jump into the home portal of the OneTouch DAO service. Now, this homepage will show you an overview of all the endpoints that has been configured. Now, what you can do is you can configure. If you use, for example, O365 mailbox, you can configure an application or a service account. And application means usually that it has broader access. With a service account, you can specifically hook up to specific mailboxes which need to be accessed. And so you're using then the OTD really as a proxy. And so the endpoint is talking to OTD. And OTD will talk to Office 365. That is one of the modes which you can use. But there is also a sort of pass-through mode. So when your authentication will jump directly through OTD, by just pointing it to OTD, and it will pass it through only one to O365 mailbox. Now you can also hook it up to your Exchange on-premise. So if you're still using that, there's also a possibility. You can also hook it up to a Google mailbox if you want, so it's very flexible. Now, under devices, as you can see, you can find my Studio X30. So you can see it's connected, as the status says. And also, what is important, it's auto-registrated. So I'm not pointing my OneTouch DAO to the OneTouch DAO. Now I'm going directly through it. So the OneTouch DAO just adds the correct information to show that join button on the Studio X30. And so that's very important, the auto registrate. That is one of the options. So as you can see here, you can also look at the status of the connection. So my Studio X30 here is connected to the OneTouch DAO service, and the OneTouch DAO services are connected to Office 365. And if you click on the specific links, you can also get additional information about that. The last calendar update was 6 minutes ago, and so you will see the polling interval here. And as you see, I'm using the credentials from myself directly to Office 365. Now, if you want to find out more about endpoints and how to integrate them, you can click on the help. And here it will show you a lot of information, for example, for group series or trio. As I said, you can use it to point it to OneTouchDAO using credentials automatically generated by the OneTouchDAO, or you use auto registration. And I use that a lot because it makes life really, really easy. So let me show you on my endpoint how I do that. So here I got the web interface of my Studio X30. So I use that a lot just to verify if OneTouchDAO service is working. So you log in to your Studio X30, I'm doing here, you go to the servers, and here you can find the server configuration. So you go here to the calendaring service, and as you see, it's registered. And the important point is here that you use as the exchange server the OneTouchDAO. But I don't use here any credentials from the OneTouchDAO itself. You just point it to it. So it will go straight through it and go by itself to Office 365 to retrieve the information from the mailbox and show you that join button. I think that's very good to know. So I'm going directly through it. And that is also something which you see here in the documentation, which I'm using the auto registration. I think that's very important. Or you use it as a direct proxy, first to OTD, and then the OTD will pull using the application or service account, will pull the Office 365 mailbox. These are very important things to know. Now, relays, that is more if you got Cisco endpoints, so you can also push that to Cisco endpoints if you got an on-prem. So a Cisco endpoint is not pulling, but expect you to push an invite to a Cisco endpoint. So if you got Cisco endpoint, it's also a possibility, it's able to push it. And that will replace the TMS, because otherwise you will get all kinds of double invites on the Cisco endpoints. Now, under settings, you can find some specifics on the meeting invites. So here you see all the parsing, which you can turn on and off. And you see it's not only Zoom, but it's also other parties where it can do and provide the join button. And also, you can do some privacy settings. And so in case you got town hall meetings or an executive meeting, and you don't want to show up the information on an endpoint, you can also hide that if you want. So there are some privacy settings which you can do. This is the OneTouchDAO. I think it's pretty straightforward, but a lot of people were asking me about how does it look like and where to configure what. So this is, I think, very, very good to know. And in the Studio X30, what I also do, always do, is test it right here. Very simple. And you should be able to get your invites. Of course, you schedule those invites using your Outlook, your Zoom, your Teams invite, your Connect info, etc. And then it should be it. It's very, very easy. Now, also, you can add Lens later on. So Lens is new cloud management platform. It's freely available. It might have some premium features in the future. But also in Lens, you're able to configure that. So in Lens, when you log into this portal, you will see three tiles. And in those tiles, you will find all the information. So you got an inventory tile, which will show you all the devices. You got an action tile, which will show you the devices which are offline or need action. And you got your insights. First, let me show you the inventory. So if you go here on the inventory, you will find here a Studio X30, for example. Now, what you can do is you can jump in here, and then you can also configure the one touch down information right here. And so here you'll find the calendaring, the settings, and the same thing. So you can also at the end, when locally is working on your Studio X30, you could plan to roll out multiple of them. It might make sense to just build your policy here from a lens where you can all centrally manage them. So if you're planning to use it in Teams mode or in Zoom mode, please use those management platforms from those providers. So for Teams, you got Teams Admin Center. For Zoom, you got the Zoom Admin Center. But if you're gonna do the multiple protocols, if you're planning to use it with all those different providers, yes, then you can use Lens, which will be extended in the future also with headsets. Trio is already in there, etc. So there's a lot of things going on, and I would really recommend to start using and testing it. Now, here ends another coffee tech break session. As I said, I'm always trying to keep it within one or two coffees, but there's always a lot of information out there, and I guess hopefully these sessions are helpful to you to make the right decisions for your meeting rooms.